I feel inspired and just a little bit small. It's like, oh my God, that's so good. That is so good. And let's give credit to where credit is due. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Brooks Andrus. He is not only the brain trust behind Camtasia and the track mats, but he's also one hell of a motion graphics artist. What I've got here is this onion skin circle pulse transition, and I'm going to right-click. I'm actually just going to ungroup it so that we can work on it. Now, what he did with his is he made his red. Like I said before, it doesn't matter what color you're creating when, or what color you're using when you're creating track mats. I'm going to zoom in on that timeline quite a bit, and you'll see what he's doing here. There we go. Okay, so he's got these circles that he's growing up and then shrinking, growing up. And then shrinking, growing up, and then shrinking. And he has animated multiple times what looks like five clips in here. So I'm gonna click on here and let's ungroup that so we can see what the heck. Actually, you know what? No, I'm gonna undo that, my bad. Because if I ungrouped it, I was gonna have to redo all those animations. I don't wanna do that. So let's just hit the plus sign. And you can see that I've got one circle, two circle, three circle, four circle, five. And one of the great things that I learned from other motion graphic artists is that they repeat things and they'll stagger them ever so slightly. And it creates beautiful motion effects in that process. So he's got those five elements and he's got them shrinking up and down, up and down. And then the final one is whoop, all the way up. Okay. He's also got a placeholder on here. No, oh, I guess I ought to do what is obvious here, which is alpha, right? Alpha is going to reveal what is underneath, and he's almost teasing what's coming here. And we just happen to have this synchronized with music. Cool. I know in my library that comes with this project, I've got demo content and I've got this mobile recording. I'm going to drag down that mobile recording underneath.
We now return you to your regularly scheduled program.
And I've got this mobile recording. I'm going to drag down that mobile recording underneath, and it is going to drop it right here under the placeholder. I'll choose Ripple Replace. And now watch this, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to slide that over, and it's going to pulse up and down, and then it's going to finally go whoom. What is important, in my opinion, about this is at some point you're probably going to want to be editing this recording and you're going to be wanting to put in callouts on top of it. Well, you can. All we have to do now is a couple things. Let's put a split on this timeline and a split on this track too. And now I can group these elements. And I can rename this one to be my transition. And I'll get rid of this alpha track mat in part because now it is right underneath here. It's built into that grouping. And over here, I don't need it anymore because we're all done with our transition. We have taken good care of it. And we're done, and now we've just got the rest of our screen recorded, and I can put my callouts and zooms and anything else that I need to do as part of that. All right, your task is I want you to open this element up to ungroup it. I want you to go into the library, go into the demo section, take that mobile recording, bring it down onto that placeholder. I want you to replace it, ripple replace, and then I'm going to ask you to edit that timeline such that you sort of get rid of the transition once you're done with it so that you can go on later on to the timeline and edit if you need to. So thanks for exploring this with me. Thanks for going into the Camtasia gym together on this project, and look forward to building some muscle with you.